episode 2793, always hear the yes in the no.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people. Happy, happy day, it's Friday. Yay! And I'm so excited. You gotta be excited with me. Come on, I know you've been waiting for the weekend. It's a short week, but it still feels like a really long week. So take a deep breath. It's confession day. Confession day is just something fun, right? It just is so freeing. So come on, moms and dads. Let's always hear the yes in the no. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com so you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You know, communicating with kids is a challenge, but if you want to know your child and maintain your sanity, you have to be willing to always hear the yes in the no. Now, I am not a salesperson at all. I'm just not. In fact, I've tried to be one and sell a few things only to fall flat fast. Oh, yes. I don't even want to go into what I used to sell. Can you believe it? I used to sell water drinking stuff-a-ma-jiggers, like purifiers. Yeah, it didn't go, didn't last very well. You know, let's see, what else did I try to sell? And I really was like trying to sell you on it. I believed in the product, but it wasn't like, oh, I gotta have this. But when we think about it, right? When it comes to communicating with children, you have to be prepared for anything. For the most part, what you think is going to happen doesn't, but something else always will. Even though I don't consider myself a salesperson, that's exactly what I do as a parent. You would think that, you know, if I'm not a salesperson in the real world and I can't sell water purifiers, that I can't sell my ideas to my children. Well, that's really what we're doing. I have to sell the idea to the point that my kids are going to at least hear me out. Sounds crazy, yes, but oh so true. Moms, dads, you are responsible for the greatest sales show ever. And I must say, you are underpaid. I'll leave it at that. But regardless, if you're trying to reason with your child, good luck. It just doesn't happen as often as we like it. Instead, you're trying to convince them or sell them on the idea that you know what's best for them. And of course you know, right? But they haven't figured that out. And this isn't an easy job. One we didn't sign up for, but are required to handle. So get your hands a little dirty and market your ideas as if they were the children's ideas. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Market your ideas as if it belonged to your kiddos. I mean, come on, life would be so much easier, right? If we had a manual for everything, but then life would not be an adventure. And that's exactly how I want you to see your communication with your children, an adventure into the wild. And boy, sometimes I think you may sound like a caveman trying to talk to the bear, right? But you know what? Somehow you get through it. You never know what they'll say, but you always know they're going to shoot it straight at you. They're just going to be blunt, no filters allowed on their part. However, that's not how it works for us as a parent. When you go to market your ideas to your children, you have to always hear the yes in the no. So how can we look at this from real life perspective? I mean, because I don't know about you, man, who my children, they are testing me always. And the older they get and the more words they learn, the more testing they do to me. And you probably have had that happen. Now, if they're only going goo goo and gaga and, you know, it's mama, you are blessed right now where you are. Enjoy that season because it does not last long. Because then they grow up. And then they become young adults and they move into having their own families and making their own decisions. And you're like, hello, what have you done? You know, you want to like knock on their head and say, are you still in there? But it's giving them that freedom that they need as they grow up safely, but also being able to say, you know what, but that's really not a good idea, but it can't be your idea. I know, sounds complicated. So let's break it down. Number one, frame it as their idea. Whatever you want your child to understand or do, it's got to be their idea. Use your words to solidify what you want for them, but make sure that they see it and understand it first. So it's coming from them, not from you. For example, and these are kind of hard. Let's say you're having a conversation regarding a best friend interaction with your daughter, and your daughter is saying, "Oh man, Mom, I don't know. She just doesn't act like she used to a couple years ago. It's like she's not my best friend anymore. I don't know what to do. You know, she's mean to me. She just kind of cuts me off like it doesn't matter. I don't know. I think I'm just done with her. I just need to wipe her off and pretend we're never friends." Well, you know how well that goes. Number one, girls come and go, right? Oh, we're best friends. No, we're not. Oh, we're best friends. We hate each other. Oh, we're best friends. Oh, well, maybe we just needed some space. Oh, we're best friends again. It's this whole roller coaster. So you have to figure out, okay, is this a girl with a great family background? Like you want and you know deep down, like they're going to be friends for the rest of their life. But you've got to help the situation when all is going awry. And you do that by saying, "Well, you know what, babe? I get that you're frustrated with her. But remember that time and take her back to some time when they were just inseparable. And say, you know, when you guys hung out and, man, she broke up with this boy and then she went to this boy. And you know what? You were inseparable back then. You guys stuck up for each other. You had some issues with another guy. And look what happened. And now here you are. Is that where you want your relationship to be?" And then be quiet. See, I'm framing it as, hey, remember way back when? Remember when all of this was working? But I didn't say that. I didn't say, you know how great she is and how good you were together and, you know, opposites attract and, you know, she's a balance for you. And I think your friendship needs to withstand this craziness that you're going through. It's not about that. It's not my idea. It's got to be her idea. Okay, so frame it as their idea. Number two, wrap it in what matters to them. Think of it as sushi for your child. I think this is kind of funny. Sushi isn't sushi without rice, seaweed, and fresh fish, right? You've got all the fresh ingredients. You wouldn't get just any sushi, would you? You get what you want. So give that to your child in a way that stimulates their mind that they're getting what matters to them. Okay, so when you're wrapping this, let's take example your daughter again and your best friend and say, "You know what? You're mad at her right now. I get it. And I can remember when I was mad at my best friend and we didn't talk for months. In fact, it may have even been years. But you know what? We talk now. And I don't know where you are with her. But you know, when we were talking about when you were supporting her and the breakups and all of this and she helped you out and you guys were just really solid for each other. You balanced each other out. What do you want in a friend?" Let her answer that question and then say, "Well, don't you think she's that?" "Well, yeah, Mom, but..." And say, "Well, do you mess up? Do you make mistakes? Do you say things that you wish you hadn't?" "Well, yeah, okay." Then go back. "So what do you want in a friend?" You see how I'm wrapping it up? It's their idea. It's what matters in their mind, not in ours. So you can think of it as turning the tables. That's what we're doing. Frame it, wrap it. And finally, number three, stick it when it counts. We can battle our kids all day long, fighting, arguing, or complaining. Does not get the result you want. It's easy to do because we've all done it. I know I've done it. I don't know how many times. Probably over 100 times. Maybe hundreds of times. I have a lot of children, so there's a lot of discussions. But I try not to really fight. I know when to draw the line and either walk away, take a time out, take a breather. That's what we have to do sometimes. So I don't try to have a lot of fighting, but every once in a while, it gets a little bit heated. So you want to be consistent and stick it when it counts, yeah? You might have to be a little forceful in your tone of voice or your expectations of actions. But don't you want to give your child the gift of life? I mean, when we are trying to raise our children up, there are times that we just have to, this is it, and you have to stick it. I think of gymnastics, and they're going off the bars, or they're landing their dismount, right, from the balance beam, or they're on floor, and they're flying through the air, and they want to land before they go for their next run. It's important to stick it when it counts. That means you have to be firm. And you have to pick and choose, right? And I must say, when they back talk you, don't continually pick a fight. Let the rough waters calm so you can have a productive discussion and not a yelling match in the middle of the sea. Because a lot of times that's what we do. We just get so heated. We know we're right. I know you're right, Mom. I get it. You're right. But they don't know it and they won't understand it until years from now. And you trying to explain it is just going to get you more upset. It's going to raise your blood pressure and your child's going to go stomping off even louder. I mean, that's just how it is. And probably mumbling a few four-letter words as they walk away. I mean, let's be real. It's confession day. And you might be thinking the same thing. I don't want you to feel defeated as a parent. But when we communicate with our children, it's easy to get stuck in that. It's easy to say, oh my gosh, I just don't think I'm doing the right thing. I don't know how to get through to my child. It's not about you getting through. It's about learning where they are, understanding it, and coming around them. I know it's kind of sneaky. Call it reverse psychology. It's a strategy. It's a tool to use as a parent. So, as a parent, you have to pick your battles carefully. So what is one thing that your child needs to understand during this season? Focus on that, right? If it's, you're in a new school, you're in kindergarten, and, okay, you're not in the school, but you know what I mean. Your child's at a new school, a kindergartner, and there's just a lot of new things happening. They probably are a little overwhelmed. So maybe it's not about, oh my gosh, you got to have all this stuff together and you got to act like this and be like this and I just want you to shine like this because I want you to be the star of the classroom. That's wonderful. You want them to be the star of the classroom whether they're a kindergartner or whether they're in college or out there for the very first time living out their career dream. But you got to look at the one thing your child needs. Maybe it's just truly support. A sounding board, then be that. Let them tell you all the messes that they're in and just say, this is what you just said to me. How does that make you feel? What do you think you should do about it? You don't have to have all the answers, all right? Don't allow yourself to get distracted by all the other things that you think and believe should fall into place, but are a mess too, right? It's the one thing your child needs during this season. And a season could be 2 weeks, could be a week, it could be 2 months, it could be 2 years. You figure that out. And remember, you've got a season that is different from the stage of life. And there's a lot to look at. You know, just think about it. We as parents, we're probably jugglers, honestly. We got to be able to juggle a lot of things. And be very careful, though, with your own heart. Yes, this is where you have to be secure in what you are doing as a parent. Because you're human too, and your feelings get hurt. So just know that this too shall pass, and that you may get hurt. It's all right. That's why you could come here and listen and say, okay, I guess I'm not the only one who's going through this. You can talk to your mom or your husband and say, this is what I'm feeling. I just need to get this out. Your best friend, right? But when you do win a battle, go quietly to the bathroom to celebrate your win. That might be the only private space you have left in your house as a mom, or even for you, dad, too. Celebrate it. Own it. Say, yes, finally. It's only taken me 3 years for them to get this. And guess what? It may take 10 years before you see fruits of your labor. And I'm here to tell you that's okay. Kids are great, but they take a lot of work and require consistency. So love unconditionally, knowing that you are blessing them for the long run. This is your long-term investment. Always hear the yes in the no and help them master today to impact tomorrow. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.